I'm joined by two-time Olympic champion Cheryl Pounder and CBC Olympics analyst. Cheryl, it is so great to see you, but devastating day yesterday for women's hockey.
Yeah, devastating, gut-wrenching, heartbreaking. I remember sitting on a couch in 2003 and being told that I wasn't going to China because of SARS with Team Canada. And I remember crying, thinking the dream, the work, where is it going from here? And that wasn't even, or can't even be close to what these women are going through right now after the tumultuous years that they have been through, one international event in 3 years.
Dr. Strang, Nova Scotia's chief medical officer, said, "I'm really comfortable with the plan we have in place."
They have a very strict protocol, and they essentially, if they come here, they will be in a bubble that they will have no interaction with Nova Scotians. That tournament does not, in my opinion, does not present a risk of transmitting, bringing COVID and then transmitting it into Nova Scotia.
I got to ask, what changed within those 24 hours?
Well, isn't that the question that I think everyone is asking? And I'm not sure, you know, if the general public has an awareness of what was put in place to keep them safe. And of course, we're in the middle of a pandemic, and everyone's worried about the health of their citizens, and rightly so. I wish we all had an answer, more of sort of a scope or lens into those hours. But certainly, I think it was the premier of the province that made the ultimate decision that he felt it for the safety of his residents, said that was the way to go.
And that's Nova Scotia's prerogative, right? And yeah, their priority is the health and safety of Nova Scotians. And I commend them for that. But you also got to ask, we recognize it's the most locked down area of this country. So why was there no plan B?
The very thing or reason why there was a belief that the tournament would go ahead was because how safe the province, how great the province has done is containing the pandemic. And that's actually what ended up shutting it down. So I think from Hockey Canada and the IIHF's perspective, they really felt that it was going to go. And that's the clearest message that we are getting, is that, you know, we did have a strong belief that it was going to go after they pushed it back the month.
Well, you said it a lot more eloquently than I could ever, but there's only been one women's world championship since Pyeongchang, which is quite alarming, especially when you think of the optics of how many major men's tournaments have gotten off the ground. World juniors this year, of course, U18s have been moved to Texas. Our women's U18 completely canceled. Men's world championship set to be contested at the end of May. So again, I'll ask, how important is it to figure this out and to host this tournament?
Well, and from what I understand is Renee Fasel and Tom Rennie, for that matter, with Hockey Canada, are saying that it is a priority. And I guess we're going to find out. These women, for whatever reason, have found themselves in a situation where they have not competed for a few years now. The evaluation process, the growth, the visibility of the game is all at large here. And it is time. I think the priority has to be to play. The flights were being chartered privately, and there were lots of things that were thought of. And of course, again, you know, everyone has the opportunity to make the decision they feel is in the best interest of their province, but it's a real tough day and a tough pill to swallow for the sport itself that kind of keeps getting pushed down. There were a lot of tears in Halifax yesterday, and it was heartbreaking. Really, I didn't even know how to send messages to some of the athletes, because, you know, having played, you know, I can say, you know what it's like to represent your country, but to have it taken away time and time again, I know how I feel, and that can't even be close to what they're feeling. And so I just hope that the proper steps are put into place to ensure that this process, that these women do get an opportunity to get on the ice.
Thank you so much for joining me, Cheryl.
Thank you.